The first time I ran it, because it's a tradition, it's called Sunday of Orthodoxy. This is really not a good visit of church, Catholic or Orthodox, the right church. It's from the Greek. Because the writing, and there's a biblical tradition, we bless the icons and crosses and we have candles as well. But so if you have something with you and that wasn't blessed, feel free to place it before the tetrapod at the end of the divine liturgy. I will bless that. Blessed be the kingdom of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and forever and ever.
Thank you.
same, thus commend ourselves and one another, alive to Christ our God.
Who's ancestor. Brothers and sisters, by faith, Moses, when he had grown up, refused to be known as the son of Pharaoh's daughter. He wished to be ill-treated along with God's people, rather than enjoy the fleeting rewards of sin. Moses considered the reproach borne by God's anointed greater riches than the treasures of Egypt, for he was looking for a reward. What more shall I recount? Have I no time to tell of Gideon, Barak, Samson, Jephthah, of David, and Samuel, and the prophets, who by faith conquered kingdoms, did what was just, obtained the promises, they broke the jaws of lions, put out raging fires, escaped the devouring sword. Though weak, they were made powerful, became strong in battle, and turned back foreign invaders. Women received back their dead through resurrection. Others were tortured and would not receive deliverance in order to obtain a better resurrection. Still, others endured mockery, scourging, even chains and imprisonment. They were stoned, sawed in two, put to death at sword's point. They went about, garbed in the skins of sheep or goats, needy, afflicted, tormented. The world was not worthy of them. They wandered about in deserts and on mountains. They dwelt in caves and holes in the earth. Yet, despite the fact that all of these were approved because of their faith, they did not obtain what had been promised. God had made a better plan, a plan which included us. Without us, they were not to be made perfect. Therefore, since we, for our part, are surrounded by this cloud of witnesses, let us lay aside every encumbrance of sin which clings to us and persevere in running the race which lies ahead. Let us keep our eyes fixed on Jesus, who inspires and perfects our faith.
Peace to you, reader. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
Ascending and descending on the Son of Man.
Glory be to you,
is Phil, a long cantor, and also his wife now, 5 years since she died, and 4 days after the death of Phil. And the liturgy was presided by his son, Murray. We have St. George's Parish. Family would like to express our sincere condolences to the family of Claire. Her mother died beginning of this week on March 1st, and Maria, she died in the 91st year. So she had a beautiful, long life, not necessarily free of pain or something. So may she rest in peace. So she died, and the funeral service will start tomorrow night at McCormick Funeral Home. So please go visit if you forgot. So visit our website, every details is there. But McCormick Funeral Home, visitation 2 to 4, and then 6 to 8 with prayers, panakita at 7 o'clock, and then Divine Liturgy Funeral Mass on Monday at 11 o'clock. And then we'll, from the church, we'll proceed to Resurrection Cemetery, and after Resurrection, interment at the Resurrection Cemetery, we'll have a memorial luncheon at Dante Club. I will make the exact address, those who will be able to follow us. And as you know, the ropes are gone, so there's no need to, so as of March 1st, the capacity was lifted out, so whatever we have in church, we can have, you still wear the mask if you're able to, and but there's no distancing per se, or the numbers that we are allowed to have, so whatever we have, we can have in church. And again, those who are not able to, for whatever reason, we are recording Divine Liturgy on Saturday evening, and it goes on our website. And last Sunday, we had an ecumenical, or interfaith ecumenical, because I included prayers, non-Catholic prayers as well, here in our parking lot, and we had tremendous response from people who attended, hundreds and hundreds of people attended our prayer vigil, and because what really happened, as you know, on February 24th, Russia invaded Ukraine, and this is the largest possible threat into international global security since World War II. And as we had those prayers, you know, there are links, those who are able to make a donation towards humanitarian help in Ukraine, so we raised over $7,000 over that day, night, and people are still contributing. And then probably for me personally was the largest gift I received, or someone else received, that was just on the receiver end, you know, deposited in the parish, was, I think it was $47.85, one kid brought all the money she had, and the beautiful card, and she said, this is what I have, I don't have it anymore. She gave everything she had. And a beautiful card with prayers for this evil that is attacking light to stop. Every Friday, Station of the Cross and the memorial service, the regular weekly Divine Liturgy on Thursdays. And then those who are looking for their tax receipt mail, this year it's transition year. We have one treasurer retiring, one taking over. So we mailed, he mailed a couple sort of installments. So please be patient. They will come. And if you still didn't get it by the end of this week or so, call me, and then I will revisit what's happening. In the Father, and of the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. With a question in today's gospel, can anything good come out of Nazareth? Nathanael has some opinions, some assumptions about the town of Nazareth. So the question is, do you or do I ever make any assumptions? I've seen this time, or I've seen his time. He or she will never change. She's always so negative. I know what she will say before she even opens her mouth. He will never understand. He never does. It has always been like that. It will never get any better. Nothing good can come out of this situation. So people of faith, people like Nathaniel, people like you and me make these and all sorts of other assumptions every day. Sometimes our assumptions are about other people, how they will behave, what they will say, what we can expect, what they think or believe. Other times we look at particular situations, and that could be your marriage, the state of the Middle East, or the war in Ukraine, or our church, Catholic Church at large, or a teenager trying to grow up and we declare it's hopeless. So we are sure nothing good can come out of that situation. Then there are those times we look at ourselves or part of our life perhaps. Maybe it is a secret we have carried for years. The illness we face each day. The addiction we hide. The hurts we have caused others. The loneliness. And lostlessness or grief. And we say it will never get any better. How can anything good come out of this? We may or may not speak our assumptions out loudly, but they are rattled through our heads and influence what we do. You know what happens when we assume, right? The old saying has some truth in it, but I'm thinking of something else. The assumptions we make, they destroy relationships. They destroy love and life. We think we know more than really do. Assumptions act as limitations. They narrow our vision. They close off the possibility of change and growth. Our assumptions deny the possibility of reconciliation, of healing, a different way of being, or a new life. Ultimately, they impoverish our faith and proclaim there is no room for God to show up and act. So it is no coincidence that Nathaniel is sitting under a fig tree when he makes his comment. It is the fig tree that gave Adam and Eve the leaves behind which they hide from God themselves. It is the fig tree that Jesus will later curse for producing no fruit, no signs of life. So assumptions become our hiding places. They're not fruitful. They keep us from engaging life, ourselves, each other, and God at the deeper level. Nathaniel doesn't doubt that God will fulfill Old Testament promises. He is not surprised by it. And thus he doesn't even question that Philip could have found the one about whom Moses in the law and the prophets spoke. What he is shocked about, and he actually voices his disbelief, is that could come out of Nazareth. Nathaniel has as much faith as the guy next door. But Nazareth? No way. No, not from there. Can anything good come out of Nazareth? And each and every one of us have our own Nazareth. We think they are about other people, they about particular circumstances, or even pieces of our lives. Mostly, however, our assumptions are about us, about our fears, our prejudices, or guilt, or losses, or wounds. We take our past experiences, real or imagined, and project them onto another person or situation. Assumptions keep life shallow and superficial. If we assume, then we do not have to risk a deeper knowing and being known. At the deepest level, our Nazareths are about our understanding of God. We just cannot see how anything good can come out of Nazareth. We cannot believe that God could be present, active, and revealed in Nazareth, whether it be another person, a relationship, or a situation, or our own life. It is so hard to see life in the midst of death, hope in places of despair, and the good and beautiful in what looks like the bad and ugly. It is sometimes easier to assume, for us Nazareth is a blind spot. For God, however, Nazareth is the place of God's manifestation and self-revelation. So it just seems so ungodlike to show up in Nazareth, whether it is a town or a person or a situation. Nazareth is too common and ordinary, even uninteresting. Shouldn't the person or place of God's coming be more deserving, special and acceptable, more holy, better behaved, likable, more regular at church, someone who prays more, who is dressed better? The Nathaniel in us has a particular set of conditions or prerequisites that must be met before God will appear and act. That says more about us than it does about God. God does not allow himself to be limited to our assumptions. For every Nazareth, there is an invitation to come and see. For every assumption we make, there is a deeper truth to be discovered, a new relationship to be experienced, and a new life to be lived. Our Nazareths become the place of God's epiphany. Over and over, Jesus shows up from the Nazareth of our life and calls us from under the fig tree. Whenever we leave the fig tree, we open ourselves to see God present and at work in the most unexpected places and people. As the assumptions fall, a new life and a new world arise. The fulfillment of God's promises and earthly life happened in Nazareth, the last place we would have thought that possible is the first place God chooses. Come and see. Our salvation and healing happened where we thought nothing could happen. Reconciliation and love are revealed in relationships we were certain nothing good would come out of. The seemingly hopeless situation of life began to bear fruit. Words of forgiveness and compassion are spoken by people we were sure could never say such things. God puts lives back together in Nazareth. There is more happening in Nazareth than we ever thought possible. You see, not just anything good comes out of Nazareth. The one who is good comes from Nazareth, and his name is Jesus Christ. In the Father, and in the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Let us all say with our whole soul, whole mind, let us say. Almighty Lord, the Father, we pray, hear us and mercy. Compassion, we pray you, hear us and have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy.
Those who pray for most holy universal Pontiff Francis, Paul Rome, his beatitude, Patriarch Philip as well, those reverend for the Lord's and John, the Bishop Ryan, for those who serve, have served in Holy Church, Spiritual Father, in Christ. And heal this land. May he give Ukraine peace and a chance to develop as a nation that values truth, justice, and freedom, all rooted in the goodness of God. Let us pray to the Lord. who made the living on your presence, who make great wonderful mercies, those who come to us for all our transgressions.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
For your merciful loving God, give glory to your Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and forever and ever. O God, in the greatness of your compassion, we pray you hear us and have mercy.
Forever and ever.
Amen.
is my body, which is broken for you, for the forgiveness of sins. Especially from the Holy Immaculate Blessed Virgin Lady, the Mother of God and ever Virgin Mary.
It is you, O Lord, who creation rejoices, the angelic ranks of all the human race, sanctified temple and spiritual paradise, virgin's pride and boast, from whom God is made flesh and became a little child, and he who is our God before all ages. He made your womb a throne, and he made it wider than all the heavens. In you, O full of grace, all creation rejoice. Glory be to you.
Among the first men, Mother of the Lord, our most holy and merciful Pontiff Francis, Paul of Rome, he's the Pater, say this well, most reverend, with Paul, the Lord, and God, the Bishop Ryan, though for the sake of the Church is granted, that may live in peace, safety, honor and health for many years, and rightly part the word of your truth.
And the world only Amen.
And grounded with one voice, one heart, may glorify, sing the praises, your most honored, magnificent name, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and forever and ever.
Amen.
May the mercy of our great God and Savior, Jesus Christ, be
Lord,
for the angel of peace, and may God guide and guard our souls from the Father, the glory of yours, Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and forever and ever.
Rejoice in the Lord, all you just, praise manifest our worship.
from you, Father God, and bless your inheritance.
We have seen the true light. We have received the heavenly Spirit.
Blessed be God.
We have followed the true faith. We have worshiped the undivided Trinity for having saved us.
Always, now, and forever.
Amen.
heart of God fill, and make their memory everlasting. Liturgy during the Lent, we think I will start in Ukrainian, and we'll recite in your English.
For our sake, you suffered the passion of Jesus Christ, Son of God, have mercy on us.